Hello everybody, this is Sonya. I'm in Australia and I'm coming on today because I want to do some slow stitching, but I'm going to use all stuff that I have, you know, it's been secondhand, reclaimed, whatever, however that goes. So I've got a piece of this furnishing stuff that I got sample, you know, the samples that they have at the curtain making places and things like that. A bit fray. Anyway, so I'm thinking I'm wanting to make a cover for a journal, so I need it to be the size that I want it to be. And usually I haven't actually got, well, I do have a journal here that I'm nearly finished, but I've got one that I'm going to start on, or that I have got. Let me just get it out here. Is this one just, I've just got this cover for temporary purposes because I didn't want to use that. It can just, it'll be, maybe not that one. I've got another one here. Here we go. But this is only small. It doesn't matter, I suppose. This is only a tiny one I made. And I can just make it fit that, maybe. Usually I make a journal 7x5. So how about I do that, this for that size, and then I can go and make the journal fit in there. I've actually probably got one here somewhere, the pages all ready to go, just not visual to me at the moment. So let's make this. So you want 10 inches one way. So we need 10 inches. Now this is only very fine, and that's good because it's good to sew on. Good to sew on if you're going to put, we're going to add pieces to it, so it's going to be really good to sew on. Now I'm going to just get a felt type needle here, and I'm going to just pull out a thread. Hang on a minute, I can't follow that line there, can I? Well, I could, look at that. I could follow this one. It'd be the size, you know, that I need it to be. Rightio, so we'll get that one out. And then I can just cut down that piece. I've got that thread, and then I can, back in there, have 7 inches this way. So, excuse me, I've got to see here that I can just pull that one out to there, because it'll work. And cut that off. I'll cut this off first before I do any more. You just have to follow the line then, look at that. So if you get something that's very light, you know, like one of these sample things, or a hanky, or a doily, serviette thing, you know, whatever sort of thing you want to use, and by this way, what did we do? I'm confused myself now, aren't I clever? Okay, so measure this across here, and then I see I've got all that frilly there, haven't I? Okay, and that's not going to be big enough because I said, what is this? Sorry, 10 inches. I've got all that, it doesn't matter. I can cut that off in a minute. Yeah, it's not going to lose any, am I? Sorry, just can't just quite see that, but I have got, oh, that's weird. Why is that back to front? Well, I've never noticed that before. I hope I'm not filming this upside down, am I? Remember the other day I did a video and showed you everything upside down. I never realised this before, that that's on that side. Couldn't you be looking at what I'm... How come that's over there? That's not. dear. Sorry, people. Anybody who's just tuned in, sometimes I don't make mistakes like this. Sometimes I just don't make mistakes like this, but oh dear, I'm sorry, people. Anyway, so I've got that one down to where I want to be. I'm going to take this down. I'm going to make this about not quite 8 inches, a bit over 7 inches, this one, because I always add a piece of something around it anyway, or we can put a bit of decoration, or if we haven't got enough or whatever, so that'll be right. So I'm going to cut this down here. I'm terribly sorry about what I was just looking at a while ago. I could see something completely different into my camera than what I was showing you, and it was really weird. really weird. Yes, he's it's right now. Nobody panic. Oh, nobody panic. Anyway, if you like my videos, can you please like and subscribe and share if you want to share me videos. I know when I did the one with the pin cushion where I put the magnets in it, everybody shared that and I got a lot of views on that, and that was really nice of you. Thank you very much. And it was really kind. Now, this is a thing for rolling the fluff up. I do like to have one of these. These are just a closed one without the handle on it because it's only gets in the way, and then you just roll up your bits of thread off and you haven't got so much thread hanging around, but that's always what it's like here in my house. If you don't go out the door as soon as you get it, if you get up and get changed, you don't go anywhere near the craft room unless you want to be going out covered in fluff or where I've been working. But I try to keep it tidy, try to keep it the place with not too much fluff and things about. It's a bit hard though. Anyway, so that fits on there good, doesn't it? So this is going to be the cover right now. It's pretty good. So for now, I'm going to use things like bits that I've got off, and I've showed you these before, that I've got off other things. So I've got a blue bird. These are off around the edge of these hankies. I've cut out these trims. So I've got them. All these here are parts that would be on hankies, and there's that one. That's nice. I don't know what I'm going to. I'll slow stitch the thing itself, but I don't think I'll be sewing much on it. You know what I mean? I want to use the embroidery piece in that, so you can see that you don't have to do it. You don't have to sew it if you don't want to. It's not that I don't want to, I just thought I'd show you how to make it and have embroidery on it without doing it. But you can save all these things from the rubbish, can't you? You don't put it all in a landfill. There's like somebody's little dogs out there got away or something. I hope it's not ours. I don't think it just doesn't sound like her. There's another bit. I like this bit too. Oh dear, we've got lots of bits. Oh, and that bit. Right, I've enough of those. I don't know. We'll have to see. I've collected these up over many, many years, okay? So please don't judge me. I had a fetish about hankies, and I was buying them all the time. Didn't know what to do, and I'd be portful. And I decided I'd just cut the good bits off and just leave the rest. So this here come off this round of the hanky as well. And when I've finished eliminating the ones I don't want, they'll probably be none of these really bright colours. You don't know, though, do you? See, some of them actually are not embroidered. They're just a stamp. But there's a stamp on. That's nice, that blue one. Righto, so we've got some of those. We've got plenty of those, actually. Maybe too many. But anyway, let's see how we go. Now, I don't need that bit. I do want one. Hang on now, we'll see what we're going to do. We're going to put something else on here too. So we're going to get a bit of each things. Bit of each. So in here I've got things that I've stamped on, other things that I've cut out. These come off material. Look at the cat, isn't that gorgeous? His blue cat. Oh my dear, I might have to have a blue cat. Okay, the road to a friend's house is never long. I think that's what that says. Yeah, that is really nice. These come off a piece of fabric that I bought many years ago. They did, and there's some ones too. I was going to have to try and get them all matching. Sorry about this, I've got an itchy eye. I do like that, so we probably can cut a bit off of that. We need a piece with a bit of wording on it, a bit of words, some words, look. There's words. That one's got little footprints, that little bit of ribbon. This is really pretty. There's something I've made earlier. So is that. We'll leave those over there. So this is off fabric. These little flowers. I think, is that on a thing? Oh, no. When I meant to say a thing, I meant a few things got mixed in here when I was sorting them. Well, you see, you can get fabric and get stuff off that, can't you? And these are trims. that you buy. This here, I really love these. I love the cross stitch things. I do like the cross stitch bits. It's something we're working on one day. I'm going to work on that one day. I just have so many things that I want to do. It's just really hard. I come in here with a few other ideas. That'll keep that out because I might need that bit. Righto, so did I get a bit with some writing on it? I did, after all that fidgeting. And then I've got some more here with these. No, wait a minute, they're under this one. I could, because the thing's see-through, I thought. Packet see-through, so I thought I got it out, but I didn't. Okay. What have I got here? So I've cut out of fabric pieces. Some of my favourite bits there. These are doilies that I cut up, like made flowers and things. It's hours and hours of work, believe you me. It's a lot of work, but it's good fun. You can't say it's not good fun, because it is. It's, I love doing these things. I really do. Now, where am I? I shouldn't be rushing, should I? Because I can feel it. I can feel myself rushing. Okay, so this has got a few bits and pieces in it too that have got writing on them, or pictures and things, and there's also the birds. When I say I want to use, you know, recycle stuff, well, I suppose that's what I'm going to do, but I might have that bit. It could be good, or it could be stamp pieces. So I've got some of those. But let's see how we're going to go with... Do I need any of these bits? You don't know, do you? We'll have a look at that later. Let's chop up doilies. I have made myself a really big variety of stuff by doing this. You probably think you've got nothing. Go and have a look. You've probably got everything. You've probably got everything you need. Everything you need. Okay. So, we're going to put down something to start off us off with. And I don't think I'm going to use purple. Okay. It's just me, you know. You know me. This is beautiful. Now, this come off a shirt or a hanky or something. Oh, now that needs some stitching on it, doesn't it? That'd be really good to put some stitching on, wouldn't it? But I'm going to show you how to make this without doing stitching. These are nice. Oh, I do love these bits off here. Do love these bits. Come on, come out, come out. Now I've cut them in sort of different sections. So I've got, this is a doily set or something, I think it was, or some sort of thing like that. Now that's cool. I do like that. That is absolutely cool. I got some of that lace. I get some lace. Here. This one's got a bit of fabric on it. So let's not have such a big piece, eh? Let's just put a smaller piece. I got to figure out which is the right side and which is the wrong side, because, and you can tell because the person's gone from there to there with their cotton. It's really well done, and you can't sort of see the process of which way she went. Now, what that bit, this bit here, okay, I'm going to have the cat. No, I'm not going to have the cat. Hope you didn't turn that off. I'm thinking the colours, you know. I might have to go with the blue colours. What do you reckon? I might have to go with the blue colours. And that's a beautiful butterfly. I do like this. Which way will we put him? Probably the best way is the right way up, isn't it, really? But I want him to go... Okay, that way. I'll put that there. Righto, that one can go there. Now I have to cut a bit off because it's just too big. It's just too big. And we can join it with either pieces of lace, which I think I might, or something, you know, like stitch of some sort, I suppose. And we put that one there. And then I want a bit of lace on it. This way. I do like how it's going to overlap that, because that's going to make that look nice. Now, you know, don't you, that this takes a while to decide how to do this. If you're sitting there fiddling around with something and it's taking you a long time, don't get disheartened, because that's just the way things are. You're doing this sort of thing. Now, you look at it and you think, that's going to be the front panel. So you either want to take it over here or you want to add a bit to the end of it. And I've got to figure out which way is the right side now, because I don't know if I've got it right. There's all these bits of thread on here. Let me see. I think that's it that way. But I've cut it the other way, but that doesn't matter. Now, I could leave this flat at the edge and then later on come along and put something along there that I like that will look good on the edge of it. But I don't know if I need to do that, okay? And I want to have this part here so you can't... And I'm going to put something underneath that as well, because I don't want to have that viewing through there. So let's put something else. And I don't know if I've got too much white, but then I'm going to slow stitch in there, so that won't be too much white, will it? So we think about that later. Now, I do like this one here as well, this basket. I do like that. I think that's been done by a machine. It could have been a person. Could have been a person. Ladies did a lot of attention to detail one time, they did. Oh, look at that. Now, there you go. That bit fits there, doesn't it? Now, I do like that too. That's a lovely piece. I do like that. You can stitch that on. Now, I'm going to cut this back a bit. Shall I put it under there first? Then put this on here. The other way. Which way did I have that? Anybody remember? Okay. This is going to be pretty basic, like as far as design goes for it. I'm not going to be doing too many tricky shapes. But I do think I like how that looks there. I do think I like that. Now, and I'm quite keen on this thing. It's a piece of lace. Right, where's some more different pieces? Nice pink one. It could work, I don't know. I know what I want now. I'm going to look for a piece of these squares. There's just a line of squares. Where have we got a line of squares? This one here, I might have to cut this off here because I want to use this bit or that bit. That's nice. Like it. Okie dokie. And we're going to put some doily on. Lace hanky. Actually, this is a bit of lace hanky. This piece. This one's the same as that one. Here's a bit smaller bit. Hope you can see what I'm doing, can you? Alrighty, yeah. Wait a minute. This way. Now, we can go down there like that with it. Now, let me see. I want to put... No, that's staying up there. This piece can go over the top of that piece. All right. Liking it. I'm not disappointed yet. I don't think I will be. See how we go. Now, do we need some... writing of some sort. I think this is not the right thing. It's not the right thing, and neither is this. Okay, it doesn't work for me. I'm afraid it does not work for me. This is what I probably need: some more of these pieces here that were cut off the edge of the hanky. Now I don't have to leave. I don't know if I need to leave that on there or not. Okay. So that can come down here like that. Maybe not all the way. We'll see what we do. Now we're going to cut it so it's up along here. Just this side of these squares. Now I'm sorry if this is going to go into two videos, but I can't. I've still got plenty of time. I just want to show you the setting up for this piece that I'm doing today. There's that. We could put that there, righto, because I think it's going to turn out pretty good, myself. That's what I think. I'm going to like it. Okay, now, I know that's pretty bare there, and I'm a bit, you know, well, we're going to see what happens. We've got to see what's going to happen there. I don't know if the bird will fit. It might do. I might have a smaller piece with a bird on. I'll have a look in a minute. So I've got another bit of that. If you can see what I'm doing here. And there's another bit there. But I might leave, I might just put this bit on the back cover, like so. And then, to work around that, I'll probably use something out of this drawer where the hinky bits are, I think. This is a good piece. Now, this is off an old bedspread. Many, many years old it is. Was come off of that. And that would look really cool, wouldn't it? The colour. I like the colour. But then, so you've got white. And I don't want to... Didn't finish my sentence, I'm sorry, but I just can't. I'm trying to think and do. It's not, that'll look good. That'll look good. And like before, I might have showed you that you have to make sure you put the right thing down first that you're going to be. So once you put one thing down, you can't put anything underneath it unless you don't put it all down properly in the first place, how you want it to be. Now, I'm looking at this section really most of all because this is going to be mostly the cover front. Part of that will be on the spine. So, therefore, I need it all to go together. And I'm thinking... I don't want it exactly like, you know, this will be it. I don't want to make a panel. I don't want to make that into a panel. I want it to be a bit that comes to there, say, and then we're going to do something else this way and something else this way. So it needs to work that way for me. I need to get the idea, you see. So I've got more of this. Oh, this isn't really pretty, isn't it? Need to put something underneath it again, yet again, because I want it to be, oh, hang on, we've got another piece of really nice little small piece there. That's got a nice picture on it. And I think I did something the other day with something like that, put some beads in it. Put a bit of embroidery around it, actually. I wonder what I've done with that. Anyway, it's bound somewhere, I suppose. It's amazing, you know, now in my room I can just go and find things. I think there's more of that. Oh, there's some more of those. And I've got that. Look at that. Yeah, so that's what I've been doing. Not as much, though. I don't know. Haven't been on here as much as I used to be because I just... I don't know. Anyway, hope to come back on soon and do a bit more. I'm not sure about that. I'll have to fix my leg here a minute. It won't be a sec. I've just got to move things. That's right now. Okay, so... Yes, I'm a little bit stumped. I'm a little bit stumped, but I do want to do the back as well. But it doesn't. Do we need to? Do we just need to do the front bit? Do we just need to do a front piece of cover, and then we can just have the back plane? Because doing the work on the back, it takes a long time, doesn't it? It takes a long time, and then give me a look at this here. So 5 inches is pretty cool, and you'd have it done, wouldn't you? Oh dear. I'll show you this one in a minute. This is what I've done for the... Well, the front of it... This is not what the original book I was going to put on, but I've decorated the front with beads and stuff and just left the back lace because I want it to be lace. So this journal is now the one that I've been making last because the one that was in this... going to be in the cover... is not to be sold because I'm keeping it, it's mine. I feel like I can't part with it. So this is the next one that I'm putting in my Etsy, but it hasn't quite finished yet, and I'm waiting for part. I would like to wait for bits and pieces to dry on it before I do more, so I'm waiting for that to happen, and then I'm going to do more, and then it'll be there soon, I hope. But anyway, let's see how we go. Right, now what have I found here? I've got some more bits, but these are not to do with what I'm doing, so that's going to stay back in there. Don't know why that's in there, but anyway, it'll be fine. Well, so we can just do the front bit. I do like to have the cover, though. I do like to have a full cover, because then it looks nicer, I think, if you put the whole thing together. Let me see what I can do with it. It probably needs to be not as fancy, but no, that doesn't look right, does it? I think I've made myself too much emphasis on, I mean, too big. I don't want it to be this big, so let's see. I just might put this on the front of a cover. I have a lot of those, but I want to do this one like that too, I think. I feel like I don't have the idea to go around the corner with it. I really do. My bird. The bird on there. Because I just get excited and want to put it together. You know, this that sort of thing happens. So this should probably be lace up here too, shouldn't it? Because that was just... I've taken them off there. How could I do such a thing? I really want to do this. I really want to make different to what I usually do. And I just have to make it different to what I usually make. I just kind of have to. Is that the piece that came off there? I don't think it is, actually. I think this is it. Right. I want to put different things on, you know? So this here is really something that I want to add to it to give it some more difference. I don't know how to say what I'm trying to say. Something interest. There's a bit more interest on it. Look. And we'll cut down here. I don't like cutting it, but anyway. Somebody's work. There's a lot of good work somebody's put into this. They have. And here's me chopping it up. It doesn't matter, though. These things here, I think, are all done on a machine. I think. But I'm sure you can find something that somebody else has done in one of the shop somewhere, and you can, you know, look after it then by making it really pretty and making it yours, you know, giving it lots of life. Yeah, it makes a difference when you put things down, doesn't it? It does make a difference. These colours are really giving it a bit of a lift, I think. It really is working. I just got to be... because I really like this. I do love this piece, this work. I do like that cat too. He could probably nearly go on here, couldn't he? You know, you could really bite the bullets on you and go for calcium. It wouldn't do as usual. You wouldn't usually use that, would you? Okay. But it's something nice to learn, something different. I'm trying to learn myself some more different techniques to do things with too, I wonder. Do more different things. I do, and get some into more beading and stuff like that. I really enjoy me sewing, but I really like to do other things too. Where's a piece of plain fabric I can put under that? Because I think I need something plain under here. This has changed up a fair bit along the way, hasn't it? It's gone from one thing to another. I could use a piece of this under there, I suppose. Hang on. Here we go. I knew I had something somewhere nearby, just in case. Just in case I had that. I think the cat's wrong. Oh, no, that's better. Look, it's better without the cat. Better without the cat. What about the bird? Where did you put the bird on here? Why don't you do this, Sonya? Put the bird there. Yes. Go with the blues. Look at that. Isn't that pretty? Oh, sorry about that. Oh, dear. I'm going to... Keep going. Keep working with it, Sonya. Go with it. It's fine. You're doing well. Put this on here, right? So it... Yeah, put that behind it because you need something. Yeah, and then you can put that here. You don't have to have it right to the edge because you're going to put a little bit of that down there. Then you're going to cut a bit off the bird. And you're going to make him straight. For goodness sake. You fly and fall down. Should he be up the top? Yep, he should be. He should be up here, shouldn't he? That's right. Put the bird there and take it right to the edge. Now, I'm going to trim this. I was going to cut that bit off, but I don't think I will because I'm going to put it over top of the next bit that's coming along there. Right. Nope. Yep. I want this on here, don't I? Yes, and then that bit, but it's not long enough, so I just put some more in there. Cut this off here, and I'm sorry, but this is how long it takes. I'll put a little bit of this in between it, just to, so when I put the, I want that down here. But I want this lace in this part. So when I put the lace on, I definitely need something behind that. Here we go, we've got a bit of this here stuff. We should have left something, I should have put something, what's the name, before, shouldn't I, on top of that. Instead of using that, I should have used something that's, so that'll be, you can learn from my mistakes. That would be a good idea if you put something behind it so it's not going to show up through. Now there's different colours in these different fabrics, but that doesn't matter to me. I don't mind that. I have to go up around this way. Butterfly will be upside down then. I don't mind it if it's... Sorry about all this fiddling. It'll come together. It will work any minute now. You'll be surprised. You might see. Look at that. Now all I've got to do is get the time, or the energy, whatever it is I need, to actually put some of this together to show you. And that looks good. Now I'm only going to take it over to 5 inches, so I'm going to... cut this up here. I'm going to follow this piece of thread if I can. It's very... Oh, it has disappeared now. Yeah, that's not bad though. I did alright. Okay, so now we need that bit to go up there. Right. So there. Now, have we got another bit of blue embroidery anywhere? You would have thought I would have had. With all those hankies and things that I've got in there, there's got to be another piece. But I said, oh, no to the blue, didn't I? But look at this. That's a nice piece. I do like that. I can either do one or the other. It's really hard for me to go more than one colour sometimes. It just depends. I'm doing crazy patchwork and things like that. I can do it. I just like to use my own colours a lot. I do my, I use my, oh, look at that. Well, that's jazzy, isn't it? Oh, yes, it is jazzy. And I do like how that is. I do love that piece. Now, hopefully, I can go and stitch this on, and then I'm going to come back. I'm going to not actually, like, sew too much, because you want to see it, don't you? You want to see the progress. Maybe, of me doing this. Hang on a minute, I'm going to move this over so I can cut this bit off. I want this bit. And you know what I might do? Instead of having all these pieces underneath, I might just get one the right size. Okay, before I sew that down. And that'll make you happy, won't you? You'll be able to have some idea what you're doing, won't you? Now that'll be good. There. A bit there. What do you reckon? Do you think that'll look all right when I fix it? Right, needs a little bit up here. A little bit of this bluey colour. So as you can see, I've made it all out of the one thing mostly. Well, when I say the one thing, I've used to only use the bits and pieces from one of these doilies. Oh, and the bird, of course. Now that'll have to go there. Okay. What do you think? That might look all right. Maybe something here too, but we'll work on that. So I better go now. I mean, I know I haven't been on here for the full time, but I just wanted to show you how I'm going to work this out and how long it takes. I'm going to just put that on the head, and this is how long it takes. Because it does. It's fun. You know, it's really worth it, you know, to trial and error with everything and to get it going. I mean, I hardly ever come on here with prepared, because then I'd think, well, that wouldn't be good. I'm ready to go. But anyhow, you know what I mean? I can't do it. I just can't. I can't do it because I changed my mind and I want it to be how I want it. You know what I mean? So I started out with a book cover. Now I just got a book front. Actually, I might even turn this into a bag, because now that I've got the background and this the bit of the idea that I've got here, I could take it a little bit further either side and make a bag. Because I've done a heap of journal covers, and I thought I could just do a slow stitch bag in the end, couldn't I? Gee, the what's name heading on this would be interesting. Anyway, thank you everybody for watching, and I hope you like what I do. You'll see how I sew and everything if you keep coming back on here and watching me. I do lots of different things, and I really love to read your comments, even if I don't get to answer them all, because once one lot goes and I put up another video, then that lot's not there for me to look at. Well, it is there, but I have to keep going back and finding things. And it's just, but I'm here, I promise you. And I can read your comments, and I love when you comment and the nice things that you say for me. And even if you have got any difficulties, you know, you need to let me know, but be nice. Okay, thank you very much for watching, and I'll come back on here and we'll do some more slow stitching for our bag, which I'm going to extend out this far by putting another piece of material underneath it. I'm going to find a linen serviette thing, you know, and that'll fit under there really good, because these are only very light thin pieces. Okay, and use linen or something, or cotton. Don't use a really tight knit or tight weave fabric, because you'll have a terrible time trying to sew through it. Do not use polyester. A lot of people use polyester to try to sew through that. It's just not good. You need cotton fabric or something like that, okay? But I've told you these things before. And I just looked, I spied this. I just spied this, look. I know I said I'm going, but you know me. All right. Isn't that pretty too? You see, it could turn into something. It's going to be something nice, you'll see. Okay, I hope I can get back on here tomorrow. What's tomorrow? Wednesday. Yes, I'll come back in tomorrow and I'll do a bit more. I haven't been outside for about 10-11 days. It's too cold, it's freezing. Anyway, I better let you go, and I'll talk to you later. Now stay safe, and everybody go and do a bit of crafting. And anything else I need to tell you? Do you want me to? No, I can't think of anything. Anyway, if you have any questions, just put them down the bottom, and I'll either answer you on there, or I'll come on here and then I'll answer any questions. Okay, thank you everybody for watching. I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.